The Blood of Lathander is a legendary mace that you can find in Rosymorn Monastery. It grants you three unique abilities. Lathander's Blessing automatically revives the wielder should she fall in combat. In this fight, Shadowheart has very low health and will be knocked out on the next hit. However, the weapon's special ability immediately revived her. The description also states allies within a 9-meter radius will be healed, but this appears to be bugged at the moment. Lathander's light eliminates a 6-meter radius with holy light. This blinds fiends and undead, unless they succeed a constitution saving throw. And lastly, this weapon allows you to cast Sunbeam. It was said here that you can recast Sunbeam multiple times within 10 turns. However, this seems to be bugged as well. You can only cast it once, and then it requires a long rest to recharge. You can get to Rosymorn Monastery by taking the mountain pass, near the place where you meet the Githyanki patrol. There's also a path west of the goblin camp. Run straight until you reach the ancient sigil circle. Then follow the path north. Have the strongest in your party turn the cable car wheel, and then board it. Go east to find the monastery's entrance. Since the main doors are locked, you must find another way in. To the left is a broken glass window. You can enter here. You will need to fight the kobolds in this area, but they won't put up much of a fight. This path will take you to the upper part of the monastery. Destroy the barricade to go in. On your left is a large hall with four pedestals. One has a ceremonial long sword.
The monastery's notable keepers adorn these intricate panels. Lathandarian monasteries of this size were usually overseen by Dawn Masters. Esteemed members of the clergy.
Several of the pictured Dawn Masters remind you of monks who would dedicate their lives to mastering specific weapons of war.
Examine the stained glass window on the floor. This will tell you what weapons need to be placed on which pedestal. You will need to find a battle axe, a warhammer, and a mace. The first one can be found behind this door.
Let's crack it open.
Lockpick it. And destroy the barricade. You will need to fight the Guardian of Faith that's guarding the ceremonial battle axe. Once you have the axe, exit the room and climb the knotted roots.
Intruder! In my nest! This area was meant to be safe! Xavier, get behind Mummy!
Ideally, you should have someone that can speak with animals talk to Mummy. Convince her you're not after her nest.
Fine. Xavier! Xavier! Don't talk to it! It might have germs.
They will turn hostile if you grab the ceremonial warhammer. So if you don't want to kill Mummy, you need to be sneaky about this. If you press the shift key, it shows you the line of sight of the eagles. You need to avoid this.
What now? Over there.
Grab the warhammer and place it outside this red area.
Indolence breeds madness.
Then have a Starian sneak and get the warhammer.
What is it?
Leave the roof by climbing down the knotted roots again.
Over here.
Continue down the path, and read the old maintenance records when you find it. It gives you a hint that you'll need grease later on. The last weapon that we need is a mace. Starting from this talking bust right here, run down the stairs and over the breach in the wall. This rusty mace will do. Now head back to the pedestals, and place the weapons as indicated in the stained glass window.
The weapons I have work here too.
It will reveal a hidden pouch, containing a note and the Dawnmaster's crest. The note mentions that if anyone who's not a Dawnmaster attempts to get the blood, the traps will trigger, destroying the monastery. After this, I suggest you complete the quest Find the Githyanki Kresh first, and explore the monastery, as there are plenty to do and discover here.
You must focus on the parasite at all times. The Zathisk will do the rest.
To find the Kresh, let's start here, at this talking bust. Head down the stairs and over the breach in the wall again, but this time turn right. There's the monastery's main gate. It can be opened using a lever within this hall. Continue on and turn right down the stairs. The entrance to the monastery's basement is right here. This is also what the Githyanki call their crash. From here, run straight towards the end of the hall and turn right. There will be an ancient sigil circle here. You need to reach the Inquisitor's chamber to continue the search for the legendary mace, but it's blocked by a force field. To pass through here without a fight, have a Starian pickpocket Kithrak Thurizen. She has the Gith shard needed to deactivate the force field.
Let's go to the shadows. A very impenetrable pocket. Not even a challenge. The element of surprise. Yes, let's. Oh, it is you. Make haste. We have business to conduct.
Continue to the Inquisitor's chamber.
It's never been that simple before. Don't know why it would be now. Our esteemed guest. Please approach. We have much to discuss.
But again, don't rush this part. It has a deep impact on how the rest of the game unfolds. Once you're ready, head towards this storage area on the left side of the Inquisitor's chamber. You need to rotate these statues, but one is stuck.
The statue starts to rotate, but its rusty mechanism jams stuck.
Use grease on it, as suggested in the maintenance records.
Ah, nearly had it.
And then position the statues like this to reveal a hidden door.
this.
This leads to a secret chamber.
Remarkable that this stayed hidden all this time.
There are magical barriers here that you need to disable. This can be done by finding and destroying their energy source. Before proceeding, have Astarion disarm the Dawnbreakers first. Again, take care not to trigger the trap, and have Astarion disarm it.
Subtle steps. Never a dull moment.
This is the last energy source that you need to destroy. Approach the mace, but don't take it just yet. Doing so will activate the trap mentioned in the Dawnmaster's note. This will destroy the whole monastery. If you look closely, you will see a crest panel in the pedestal. Insert the Dawnmaster's crest here. That should disable the traps. Thanks for watching.